Welcome students to our next lecture on aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions. In previous lectures, we have seen about nitration reaction. In this category of electrophilic substitution reaction, we have seen nitration reaction. We have also seen sulfonation reaction. Today, we will see about the halogenation reactions. Overall, the substitution reactions are a total chemical reactions. We have four types of chemical reactions. One is an addition reaction. Second is elimination reaction. This we have covered it in our previous lectures also. Third is redox reactions. And fourth one is a substitution reaction. In substitution reaction, it is exchange of the group happens. Where this X is getting exchanged by Y, so it is a substitution where Y is substituting the X, or X is getting substituted by Y. Depending on the charge on the Y, we can classify the substitution reactions into two types. One is an electrophilic substitution and another as a nucleophilic substitution. If Y is electron deficient species, if Y is an electron deficient species which is having a positive charge or an empty orbital to accommodate the extra electrons, then we call it as an electrophilic substitution reaction. That is, the substituting species is an electrophile which is electron deficient. If the substituting species Y is a nucleophile, that is, it is an electron rich species. All nucleophiles are electron-rich species which has donatable electrons with them. All electrophiles are electron-deficient species which have empty orbitals to accommodate the extra electrons. So here, if a nucleophile which is electron-rich, which has a negative charge, or it has a lone pair of electrons. If it has a lone pair of electrons which are donatable, then we call it as a nucleophilic substitution reaction. So we can have two types of substitution reactions, one as an electrophilic substitution and second as a nucleophilic substitution reaction. When we look up the aromatic compounds are characterized by sp2 hybridized orbitals. So they have sp2 hybridization, and as sp2 hybridization is there, one p orbital is unhybridized. One p orbital remains as an unhybridized. So as it is unhybridized, it remains as in a plane perpendicular to the plane of hybridization. Here sp2 hybridized orbitals are all three in one same plane, separated by an angle of 120 degrees amongst them. So they are in one same plane. Let's say it is an xz plane. The unhybridized orbital will be perpendicular to this plane, which will be in a y plane. So, this y-plane orbitals for benzene ring, benzene compound, which is having 6 carbon atoms, we can show each of this unhybridized p orbitals like in this way, where this can overlap in a lateral way to form pi bonds. So, there will be an overlap between these lower lobes as well as the upper lobes. Similarly, this will be overlapping to form a pi bond. Here, these two will be overlapping to form a pi bond. So, it will be three pi bonds will be formed. But due to resonance, these pi bonds gets exchanged. Now, the pi bond is between these two orbitals. It can be between the other two orbitals also. So that this, in the next instance, this can overlap together to form a pi bond here. Or these two can overlap to form a pi bond the other way. Or similarly, we can have it in this way also. So it completes an overall circle where the upper portion above the benzene ring is also having a pi electron, and below is also having a pi electron. So we have a pi cloud above the benzene ring and pi cloud below the benzene ring, which makes it as an electron rich species. So aromatic compounds are electron rich due to resonance of pi electrons. These pi electrons of aromatic compounds attack the electrophile to form an attack, which is stabilized to resonance, and hence it gives rise to an aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions. We can see about the halogenation reactions. Halogenation reactions can be characterized as a benzene ring reacting with a halogen, say X2, to give rise to halobenzene plus HX molecule comes out. This requires a catalyst. Generally, Lewis acids are used as a catalyst for this. Like, for example, we can have a FeCl3 or we can have anhydrous AlCl3 can be used as a catalyst for these reactions to carry out the halogenation reactions. Particularly, FeCl3 and AlCl3 are very good for catalyzing the reactions, chlorination as well as bromination or the other type of reactions can be easily carried out. Now, the first step for this halogenation is a generation of an electrophile. This is common step. There are three steps for any reaction, electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction for benzenes. We have three steps. One is a generation of an electrophile. Second is attack on electrophile. And third one is a removal or loss of proton to complete the aromatization. So these are the three basic steps involved in an aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. The first step is a generation of an electrophile. In this case, the catalyst plays a very important role. Like, for example, if we take a chlorination reaction, then the chlorine molecule, which is a Cl2 molecule, this has lone pair of electrons. Chlorine is having three lone pair of electrons, each one of them. So this can react with FeCl3 to form an adduct. Where it donates its one of the chlorine atom donates its electrons to the empty orbital of Fe, that is iron, so that FeCl3 will be acquiring a negative charge and the chlorine will acquire a positive charge. So this bond electrons then moves towards this electrophilic chlorine. We will get a Cl plus and we will get a FeCl4 minus. So this way we can get an electrophile. Cl plus will act as an electrophile, which is having a positive charge, and so it is having an empty orbital to accommodate the electrons. So this way we can get an electrophile is formed by using this catalyst FeCl3. If we do not use the catalyst, then the reactions are very slow. The second step is an attack on electrophile. Attack on electrophile, like for example, if we are taking chlorination or bromination, in both ways, either it is a chlorination or a bromination, we can have it. FeBr3, we can take it so that we can have an adduct. FeBr3 over here, this will be having a negative charge, a positive charge, so that this electron moves over here. This is an intermediate, and we will get a Br plus and FeBr4 minus. So this Br plus will be acting as an electrophile, or Cl minus Cl plus will be acting as an electrophile in either the chlorination or bromination reactions. If we are taking as a bromination as a reaction, the second step is attack on electrophile. In this, the benzene ring, being an electron rich, will be attacking the bromine plus ion, so that it accommodates the electrons donated by this benzene ring into its empty orbital, and it gets a benzenonium ion or an arenium. The general name is arenium ion, while the particular name, as it is a benzene, so we call it as a benzenonium ion. If it is another aromatic ring is there, then we can call generally as an arenium ion. This arenium ion is stabilized through resonance structures, where this pi bond shifts over here so that the positive charge will be acquired by this carbon atom here, and then this pi bond will be shifting over here, the positive charge comes over here. So we have three centers of positive charges. These three centers of positive charges overall gives rise to a benzenonium ion, where the positive charge is being circulated equally by these three carbon atoms. So it gets more stabilized and we will have a stabilized intermediate which is having a positive charge. So this will be the step of attack on electrophile, where the bromine gets attached to one of the carbon atoms, which is still possessing a hydrogen atom over here, and a positive charge is being acquired by the benzylonium ion. The third step will be loss of proton and rearomatization. Because this benzylonium ion has only two double bonds are there, so it has two double bonds, each double bond having two pi electrons. So overall, there are four pi electrons are present in this benzylonium ion. Hence, it doesn't follow Hückel's rule. And as it is not following Hückel's rule, it is not aromatic compound. This is not an aromatic compound. So it needs to rearomatize itself by losing either a proton or a bromine, either a H plus ion or a Br plus ion. If it loses a Br plus ion, then we get back the bromine, we get back the benzene. If it loses proton, then we get the bromobenzene as the product. So the final step will be then a plus charge here, a proton and a Br. So this proton is lost and the double bond is formed over here, and we will get Br over here, that is bromobenzene is formed as a product. This bromobenzene has three pi bonds, so six pi electrons are there, and hence it becomes an aromatic compound. So the final step will be a loss of proton. This loss of proton is being catalyzed by the counter ion that we have generated, FeCl3, or in this case FeBr4. FeBr4 minus abstracts the proton from here and we get FeBr3 and HBr. FeBr3 again picks up another bromine molecule and carries out the reaction again. So it catalyzes the next cycle of reaction. This is our halogenation reaction. Thank you.